something interesting to take note of, which means in the ra line, that means da di do de do. So in da di do de do, right, you can actually simplify it to the ng sound. So one example is this wakaranai. So ra become ng. So wakanai. So you just learn the negative form of verbs, right? So for the ra, you can put ng. So wakanai. Shiranai. Okay? So usually that's for ra, ru, and re as well. Ri and ro, I don't really know any of it. I tried to Google it, but I don't really see anything related to it. So maybe if there's any, it probably has got to do with some historical roots or probably some dialects. Okay, so we'll touch on ra, ru, and re. So for ra, right, of course there's wakaranai. For ru, okay, I'll just teach you this grammar. This grammar is from N4. It's very easy. You just add a na to the end of the casual form, the plain form, which means the positive present form. So for example, this fuzakeru. So fuzakeru means to mess around, you know. So probably you hear it in many dramas, say don't mess with me, fuzakeru na. So you just put a na behind. So same thing, this ru can become ng. So fuzaken na. Nameru. Nameru na means don't look down on me. So nameru namenna. Namenna yo. In a sense, this is like the you remember you learned the te kudasai form, right? So we say don't do something is naide kudasai. So but that is quite polite. Even if you take away the kudasai, that's also quite polite. So this one is more of the you know, not the polite form, very very rude actually. So over here, now we go on to re. Oboerarenai. Okay, I won't talk about the grammar here, but over here the re will become m. So oboeranai. Okay, so oboerareru means can remember. Take away the ru because this is a group two verb. With a nai, so it's oboeranai. So we get oboeranai.